Hi, Active Volcanoes. Super excited to have you join me for yoga today. So your intent for your yoga practice today is patience. And patience is a really interesting, it's a really interesting thing to play with. Because in coaching with people and in working with myself, I notice patience is usually lacking when faith is lacking. And it's this like, I don't believe it's coming, I want it now, prove it to me energy that is the opposite of patience and it's the opposite of faith. But if you know something is coming, if you're certain it will be there, you can be excited for it. You can be like joyful and delighted and ready for it. But you can also be patient because you know it's not really going to make a difference if it comes now, 5 minutes from now, 10 minutes from now, 2 years from now. If that thing that you really, really, truly believe and have faith in is coming, and if it's like that amazing, it's definitely worth waiting for. And the irony in all of this is that patience and that faith and that certainty is what makes it come faster. Because you finally just surrender and you get out of your own way and then it comes. So today, in your yoga practice, you're generating patience. Patience with yourself, patience with the universe, patience with your poses, patience with your body. And as you generate patience, you surrender and allow all those things that you've been resisting with your needy now energy, you actually allow those things to just start come flooding into your life. So sit on your mat and turn on your breath. And close your eyes. And to start off your patient practice, and just start with a slow, focused meditation. Close your eyes, and sitting in silence and in stillness, patiently wait. Just know that this practice is going to be amazing. You're going to shift. You're going to get what you need. And you don't need to rush it because it's coming. So right now, we'll start practicing patience. One of the things that helps me with my patience is listening to far off distant sounds or quiet, really delicate sounds like the ticking of a tiny clock or the cars, the freeway in the far distance, or rain or children playing off in a few blocks away that you can just faintly hear. Patiently listen to those sounds. And let your focus on those sounds take away any impatient thoughts. Now put your hands on your heart. And ground into a knowing in your heart that everything you want is coming, whether it's coming now, or a day from now, or a week from now, or 7 years from now. Feel the stillness and the certainty and the peace that comes over you just when you know that everything is lined up perfectly for you. And breathe into that feeling. All you have to do is let go into that feeling of stillness and let all those things that you want delightfully unfold for you. Open your eyes and sit on your mat. Now, I'm gonna have to be patient with this camera. It's tilted. There we go. Now, if you're being patient with your body, instead of forcing it into poses today, you can use things like props and blocks for support, or you can sit yourself up against a wall or a couch to support your back. And you can just accept everything, your body, your mind, your life, for where it's at right now. Bring your left leg in and your right leg out. Bring right arm to the inside of right leg, and then inhale left arm up. And patiently breathe into the spots of your body. Feel like you have been patient with you, that you've been neglecting a little bit. And now be patient with them and let them start to open up with your breath. And just start talking to your body with the utmost compassion and patience. Say, I accept you where you are right now. And I can accept you because I'm certain I will have everything I ever want I'm certain it's coming and I can be patient. Take your left arm, lower it to neck release. And any spot of your body that's talking to you loudly, send it patience and watch how it responds. You can even say, I send you patience. Inhale, reach with the left arm to pull yourself up and take the right hand to the right side of the head and help the head up. Switch sides. Bring the left arm to the inside of the left leg. Inhale, right arm up slowly and patiently. Listening as your body opens with your breath. Now, when you get into a little sticky pocket of fascia that's not moving, breathe and patiently fill it up with breath. Warm up your body from the inside out with your big, full breath. And be patient as it slowly responds. And take your right arm, lower it to neck release. And breathe into the right side of your neck. Now, the fun thing about patience is once you've really sunk in and you've ridden the wave of discomfort past your impatience, you actually get to that place that you wanted to be all along. Inhale, reach with the right arm to pull yourself up. Then take left hand to left side of the head and help your head up. And lie on your back for elbow to knee. Interlace your fingers behind your head. Inhale, press low back into the floor. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up. Exhale, head and shoulders reach towards left leg, right leg reaches out, belly pulls down. Inhale, back to center. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up. Exhale, head and shoulders reach towards right knee, left leg reaches out, belly pulls down. Inhale, back to center. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up. Exhale, head and shoulders reach towards left leg, right leg reaches out, belly pulls down. Inhale, back to center. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up. Exhale, head and shoulders reach towards right knee, left leg reaches out, pull the belly down at the end of your exhale. Inhale, patiently come back. Stay with me. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up. Exhale, head and shoulders reach towards left leg, right leg reaches out, pull belly down. Inhale, back to center. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up. Exhale, head and shoulders reach towards right knee, left leg reaches out. Pull belly down at the end of your exhale.
Inhale, back to center. Roll head and shoulders on the floor. Put your feet on the floor. Take a big full breath. Keep breathing, filling up patiently at the top of the inhale. Fill up with more breath. Stretch yourself from the inside out. Keep filling up with breath. And then exhale everything out. Grab your roll. Here it is. Abs with the roll. Interlace your fingers behind your head. Bring your legs straight up or bend them at a 90 degree angle. Patiently accept wherever your body is at. Inhale, press low back into the floor. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up, squeeze the roll. Exhale, head and shoulders come off the mat. Pull belly down. Inhale, lay head and shoulders on the floor. Hold the breath, curl the tailbone up, squeeze the roll. Exhale, head and shoulders come off the mat. Pull your belly down. Inhale, lay head and shoulders on the floor. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up, squeeze the roll. Exhale, head and shoulders come off the mat. Pull belly down at the end of your exhale. Inhale, lay head and shoulders on the floor. Hold the breath, curl tailbone up, squeeze the roll. Exhale, head and shoulders come off the mat. Stay here, curl the tailbone up again, squeeze the roll again, pull belly down. Inhale, lay head and shoulders on the floor. Do three more just like that. When you finish your three, remove your roll, put your feet on the floor, get your block handy, and then come up, actually, scratch the block, put the roll between your thighs, and then come up into bridge. It takes me a lot of patience to stay in bridge with the roll between my thighs, so that's why I chose it. Of your body feel like they want to scream and run from this pose, say, I send you patience. I have faith that together we're transforming. Stay committed to the pose and stay committed to your breath. Be patient, knowing that I cannot hold you in this pose for an eternity. We will come out of it. Now listen to that little impatient teenager crabby voice in your head and just soothe it. Say, it's all gonna be done soon, it's no big deal. And slowly lower out of the pose, upper, middle, and low back to the floor. Take a deep breath. Roll over to your left side. And with your neck relaxed, gently press yourself up to seated. Take left hand to the left side of the head, help the head up. Dolphin pose. Actually, let's do cat-cow. My body's like, be patient with me, warm me up a little more. So do about 5 rounds of cat-cow, getting your breath fully into your body. Bring your forearms down to your mat. Wrap your hands around your upper arms and then bring your hands either parallel or clasped for dolphin. Inhale, spread the shoulder blades apart. Exhale, press hands into the mat, tuck your toes and come into dolphin. Take 5 breaths in dolphin. Experience the full range of your breath and patiently wait for your lungs to fill all the way up and completely empty. Achilles heel stretch. Walk right foot towards the midline of your body. And then lift left foot up, hooking, forking your heel. And traction your heel down towards the floor. Three breaths here. Switch sides. Set your knees down on the floor. Take 2 breaths in embryo pose. Oh. standing. Horse with Agni Sara, and then with hip opener. So grab your shirt and make a belly shirt out of it. Take your hands, heels of your hands, to the tops of your thighs. Inhale. Agni Sara goes like this. First you'll inhale, and then you'll exhale everything out. Staying empty, pull the belly back and let it go. Pull belly back, let it go. We'll do two slow and then two fast. Ready? Go. Now do two fast. Twisting horse, bend your left elbow, place it on your left thigh. Take right hand to the inside of right thigh and traction your thighs apart. Switch sides. Straighten your legs. Come into straddle forward fold. 5 breaths in straddle forward fold. Heel toe your feet together and then come up to standing. Down dog on the wall or down dog one leg up. So to get proper distance of down dog on the wall, you want to kick one leg up and reach the wall with a straight leg. So what this does is it gives you, it assures you you are a leg's distance away from the wall. And put your foot down and turn around, keeping your feet in the same spot. Next, put your hands right in front of your toes and then back up into down dog. So you can either do down dog with one leg up, You may need to be a little bit further away from the wall depending on your hamstring flexibility. Or you can come up into down dog on the wall. I'm gonna be patient with my body today and do down dog one leg up. Either do 5 breaths on each side or do 10 breaths in down dog on the wall. Come down off the wall. And stand at the front of your mat. Inhale, chair pose. Exhale, forward fold. Bring your hands to your shins. Inhale, scoop chest forward, lengthening your back. Exhale, hands to the mat, step your feet back one at a time, and then lower your knees to the floor, and lower down. Low cobra, inhale, pull yourself forward. Exhale, lower down and press back to down dog. Inhale, step left foot forward. Warrior one with a high lunge. So first you come into a warrior pose, both feet facing forward, and then turn back heel up and lower right knee towards the floor. Your foot's about a foot off the floor. Your knee's about a foot off the floor. Breathe. Be patient with this pose, certain that when you continue to apply consistency and you're patient with yourself and you unfold over time little by little, you'll get where you desire. Just hold the belief that it can happen so that you can be patient with the unfolding. Set your back knee down for lunge. Inhale, arms to the floor. Pigeon pose. Take 6 breaths in pigeon pose. Make those 6 breaths full, engaged, long breaths. Do not rush through them. hands to the floor. Press back into plank. Lower your knees to the floor and lower down. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, down dog. Inhale, step right foot forward, high lunge. Notice if you are eager for the pose to finish and just surrender into it, knowing that it will finish. What is that sweet spot you're missing out in life because you're so eager to get on to the next thing? Set your back knee down. Lunge. At the top of your breath, patiently pause. Really making the most of your inhale. And at the bottom of your breath, patiently pause. Taking the most out of your exhale. Do that twice. Pigeon pose. Inhale, bring your hands to the mat. Exhale, press back to down dog. Take three big full breaths in down dog. Inhale, step left foot forward. Warrior One, Brain Cradle. So interlace your fingers
at the base of your head and neck.
Inhale, lift belly button up away from pubic bone. Lift sternum away from belly button and then pull your abs in. With that strong, steady base, relax your head into your hands. Twisting warrior or easy twisting warrior, going easy today. So if you're going easy, place right hand on the floor, lift left arm up. If you're going full twisting warrior, right elbow crosses over left knee. As you breathe, have patience to move your breath through your whole body with every breath. Lunge, heel the butt. Set your back knee down and pad your right knee. Inhale, reach back, grab your right heel. And pull it in towards your butt. Patience to transcend any discomfort so that you can soak up the magic of this pose. Now, magic really starts to happen when you get a little quiver going on. Breathe into that. Set your back foot down. Press back into plank or hands and knees and lower down. Inhale, low cobra or cobra. Exhale, down dog. Warrior one, brain cradle, step right foot forward. I like to do my warrior one with the brain cradle with my back heel up. You have the choice of doing it heel up or heel down. Twisting warrior or easy twisting warrior. Inhale, bring left hand to the floor. Exhale, right arm reaches up. Stay patient with this pose. Stay present. Set your back knee down. Lunge, heel to butt. Breathe fully and bring your presence inward. Bring that emotional quality of certainty into this pose. You are certain you can be here in this moment right now and get the most from it. Gently let go of your foot. And then sit down on your mat. Twisting half lotus. Reach left hand behind your back to grab your right foot. Or wrap the strap around your foot so that you can grab the strap behind your back. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, cross left arm over right knee. Inhale, come back to center, switch sides. Grab your foot from behind your back with your left hand. Inhale, reach right arm up. Exhale, cross right hand over left knee, coming into twisting half lotus. Inhale, come back to center. Today, it's an extra long, patient Shavasana.
Set the timer on your phone for 23 minutes. And then just let yourself go. Make sure that you're propped up and supported. You can be comfortable. And then be patient with everything else outside of you that is waiting for your attention, waiting for you to go do, waiting for you to go distract yourself with. Just go full on in for 23 minutes, completely surrendered. Namaste.